Barely a week after the president reveals plans to let millions of illegal immigrants to stay in the U.S., new reports say there is already a surge of illegals crossing the Texas border.
Our next guest is from Australia, and he says they had the same problem down under until a conservative government took over. So should the president be taking a cue from them when it comes to immigration? Nick Adams is the best-selling author of The American Boomerang, and he joins us now on The Curvy Couch.
My favorite couch in the whole world, guys. It's great to be back. Thank you for having me.
No problem, Nick. So first off, we have an immigration problem. Are we handling it the wrong way?
I think so, Brian. Absolutely you are. The speech that the president should have given last week was, we are going to determine who comes into this country and the circumstances under which they come. If you come to America illegally, you will never get to stay. You will never become an American. We will send you home.
Right. And this is personal to you because you have applied for a green card to become an American citizen.
Sure.
And you're all hung up in red tape.
That's exactly right. And as are millions of other people right around the world that want to become an American, that want to do it the right way.
What's involved with that? Cost and time?
Well,
for you?
Incredible cost, incredible time. I mean, we're talking tens of thousands of dollars. We're talking lots of time, years that people wait. And yet, if you go across the border, if you'd been here 5 years,
boom,
all of a sudden you're in. So it's very disappointing, very frustrating, not just for me, but most importantly, it weakens America.
What is Australia doing about the very same situation? Although you don't have borders, you got water. Having said that, what is your policy?
Well, Brian, we had a terrible problem. We had tens of thousands of illegal immigrants coming on lots and lots of boats because we weakened our border protection policy. And then a conservative government came in and said, right, this has got to stop. We are a generous and caring people, but we have laws and things need to happen the right way. So we got tough because we know that weakness is provocative and things like amnesty only lead to more and more illegal immigration.
Right, yeah, the removals and returns. I mean, when you just look at the year, they've actually, it looks like, near tripled. In 2013, there were 464. In 2014, 1,385 removals there.
Elizabeth, it's liberal arithmetic straight from the Pelosi Institute, and it's the last thing that America needs.
The Pelosi Institute?
Well, I don't know if it exists, Steve, but it's terrible.
Because in Australia, they said, okay, we're going to do something about this new conservative government. We're going to do something about the illegals. If you are here illegally, you're not going to become a citizen. And then it just stopped.
And then it stopped. For the last 10 months, we have not had one single illegal immigrant arrive to Australia. Not one.
Not one?
Not one, Elizabeth. It's the great story, and it's the one that President Obama should be hailing. I mean, it hardly warrants a Fox News alert that the first responsibility of any government is to secure its borders, and that amnesty is going to lead to more and more illegal immigration.
Is there a pushback in Australia for people who say we should be opening up our borders, and Australia isn't just for Australians?
Well, you've always got the politically correct types, Brian, the same people that are behind the idea that because I'm a white Christian, middle-class male, I don't get an opinion or a voice, but if I was a naked gay Ecuadorian wind turbine engineer that got on his mat and faced Mecca five times a day with a credit line at the Bank of Jihad, you know, the world would be at my feet.
By the way, that you just described our next guest. So that's fantastic.
Well, that's good. I'm glad I could intro him. But it's really, really important that America understands that what President Obama did the other day is going to fundamentally transform this nation.
Yeah.
Well, The American Boomerang is the book. Nick Adams is the author and the man joining us today. Thank you.
Thank you, Elizabeth.
Thank you, sir.